Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with a look at the North American stock markets for Thursday morning. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are down below fair value. Dow futures currently down around 40 points, so we are looking for some selling at the open on Thursday morning. Let's start off this morning's presentation looking at a couple of 60-minute charts for the S&P 500 cash index. We had that big gap higher last week, made a new all-time high, champagne was popped, balloons were dropped. The media was incredibly happy for what had happened. And as a trader, of course, you're going to bracket that day and mark the bottom of the open gap. And those are the three lines you need to watch going forward. Of course, the most bullish thing to happen would be that we break out above that day's high. Unfortunately, we were not able to do that. And we quickly traded down to the low of that day. And then on Friday, we broke through it. This week, we've been watching to see what the market would do at the bottom of that open gap. And yesterday, we finally got there and filled the open gap. And this morning, we are continuing to trade lower. You'll notice that things have been very, very quiet since we had the big pop in the market. The volatility, the intraday price volatility of the market has been very calm, cool, and collected. And a lot of people think that the market is on pause until we actually get those employment numbers out on Friday. Now, what we're looking for on Thursday is an hourly close above 2372.08 to give us a new intraday buy signal on Thursday. Now, looking at the daily charts, what happened yesterday actually gave us a new daily sell signal for the S&P 500 cash index. It did not give us a sell signal for the NASDAQ 100, so a little bit of discrepancy there. The big cap technology stocks are still holding up fairly well. Now, mid cap and small cap stocks, micro cap stocks, not doing well at all right now. And so the internals of the stock market are getting weaker as time passes. When the market is not willing to buy microcap, small cap, high risk stocks, then it's telling you that it's not in a very healthy condition. Now, the other big headline yesterday, of course, was crude oil dropping over 5% on the day. And that drove down energy stocks on both sides of the border. Looking at the Canadian market, the TSX with the drop in energy stocks was pulled down below the lower channel line. Not a major decline for the TSX given what happened to the energy sector. Looking at Husky Energy, we're back on a sell signal. Suncor, which generated a buy signal 2 days ago, is now back on a sell signal. So we saw a lot of that yesterday where stocks that had just recently given buy signals were hammered hard by crude oil. There's the TSX Financial Services Index, unable to make a new high yesterday. It looks very similar to the Royal Bank, which was also unable to make a new high yesterday. At the same time, Sun Life was up and generated a buy signal on Wednesday. Looking at gold stocks were up ever so slightly in Toronto. Barrick was up, Agnico Eagle was up. The XAU down yesterday, making a new low for this move. If you take out all the gold stocks, and one of the stocks that is not traded in Toronto is Freeport, and Freeport made a new low for this move, so that's probably why there was a discrepancy with the XAU versus the TSX Gold Index. Looking at the chip sector, semiconductors traded back in the channel yesterday, failing to make a new higher high once again. While transports, which has been down 3 days in a row, found support at the recent February lows. Looking at currencies, nothing new to report here. We've got the US dollar index up at recent highs. Of course, that index is a basket of currencies, and those basket of currencies are still on sell signals. The euro, the British pound, Japanese yen, Swiss franc, Canadian dollar, all still on sell signals. Canadian dollar looking a lot like the New Zealand dollar right now and not like the Australian dollar, which seems to be holding up the best against the US dollar at the moment. Let's finish off this morning's presentation looking at the bond market. And a lot of people are anticipating that if the Fed raises interest rates right now, bond prices are going to drop. And what they don't understand is that the bond market started selling off last summer. And this is a weekly chart of the 30-year bond. There was our last early warning signal, top of the panic zones, and we've driven all the way down here. We're down at the bottom of the panic zones right now with a pressure zone. So people are thinking that now is the time to short the market, and that is certainly a high-risk trade. The bond market is well ahead of the Fed and has already priced in a Fed rate hike, and so you might not see a move down in bonds just because the Fed raises rates. So just be aware of that. We have traded up to the upper channel line for the last couple of weeks, but have been unable to close above it. And so no weekly buy signal here for the bond market. Looking at the daily charts, they drove down yesterday. There's the 30-year bond, the TLT, and the XBB all moving lower on Wednesday. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. It looks like it's still very quiet out there this morning. Not expecting a lot of volatility on Thursday, but do expect a lot of volatility on Friday as the market will probably overreact to whatever employment numbers come out. Have a great day, and the next time you'll hear my voice is on Sunday.